And of course, the secret was this intense curiosity that came out again. This was the same curiosity that came out when I first learned to read, and I read Ab the Caveman and then started eating books up. It was a curiosity that had ended at the end of college when I focused on medicine and a career in medicine and then a career in surgery. Everything had been sort of in abeyance, but this curiosity came out and the recognition of how much I needed to know. And one reads about restlessness. There was a great pathologist named Giovanni Battista Morgagni in the late 18th century, who, when he was young at the University of Padua, was it Bologna? That was Bologna. Belonged to an organization called the Academy of the Restless. I can't say it in Italian. But their notion, the basis of their coming together, was they didn't like the theories of the time. They didn't like to stand pat intellectually. They knew there was a lot more to learn. Always restlessness, never being satisfied. And this is the way I've lived my life since my late 50s. You know, we're talking about 25 years at least. Being restless, never being satisfied with what I know, meeting people who knew a great deal more than I did in certain areas and feeling the courage to exchange ideas with them. It's actually been one of the joy of writing books. People write you letters. People get interested in knowing you, and you go various places and sit down and chat with all kinds of men and women with all sorts of backgrounds. So this has been the richness of my life. And to go back to the waning period in my late 50s, I knew that I was losing interest first in the surgical literature and then in the companionship of other surgeons. I had been very active in hospital politics. I'm not a shy person, and I always speak my mind, so I would be on this committee or that committee or the other committee, you know, the executive board. At one point, I was vice president of the executive board of the medical staff. I was secretary of the medical staff. I was interested in ethics from the beginning. Actually, what I was interested in was this notion that I call the goodness of the physician, his personal morality, how he lives his life, and how that is reflected in decisions he makes at the bedside, and reflected in his way of healing and his effectiveness as a healer. And that got me into bioethics. So when the Yale New Haven Hospital formed its first bioethics committee, I was a member. They asked me to be a member of the bioethics committee. I was eventually asked to join the group that was forming the first American hospice. It was formed here in Connecticut, in Bradford, Connecticut. So I was on the board, and I was an officer of the board. So you see, my interests, although they were growing out of medicine, were becoming much wider. Some of them had great applicability to healing. And one of them was humanism.